Even Lev can sculpt using VDM brushes, because VDM brushes make sculpting easier. VDM stands for Vector Displacement Map, and that's a high-end sculpting technique for adding highly detailed three-dimensional shapes with a single brush stroke. To make it work, first we'll need to go to Preferences, search for VDM, and tick the checkbox near the plugin name. Then it should appear in the right toolbar, under the VDM Brush Baker panel with just a few settings, so nothing complicated really. For now, we'll just need a sculpting plane, and it should create a plane with the multi-res modifier for now. We can probably subdivide it once more, so it's fairly dense now. First of all, I'll press Shift A to draw a circular mask starting roughly from the center, A then to smooth it out, until it's nice and blurry. Invert this mask. Now we can sculpt something. I will sculpt a crack in the stone, maybe. See how I'm trying to create the outcroppings, the parts that would protrude over that hole? The clay brush is perfect for that, I mean the clay strips, of course. The edge is the key to making it look cool, as it will give it some parallax. The plateau brush is pretty cool for creating this embedded bricks sort of geometry. Then finally, some scraping or trimming is a must-have, just because, you know, it makes it look stony. Anyway, if the polygons get a bit too stretched due to all this sculpting, then it could be worth subdividing it again. I'll finish it off by detailing it with the clay strips brush, mostly. A bunch of cracks here and there, and it looks complete to me. The next step is to bake it using the VDM plugin. What we need to do is open the toolbar, then go to VDB Brush Baker tab, and here we've got the name Rock Test 01, whatever. Now I will just use the default settings and click Render and Create VDM Brush. It should have dumped the EXR file with this funny color displacement map where each color represents a direction into the folder with a blend file. Then to turn it into an actual brush, let's create a test plane in a fresh blender file, give it enough density. 1 million. Cool. To create a custom brush, I'll copy the default draw brush from the right-click menu, call it Rock, and click Save. And we should be able to see this duplicated brush somewhere among the brushes. Next, I will go Texture, and I'll make sure that the vector displacement mode is actually switched on, and then simply add a new texture. And within the Texture tab, I'll point it to the EXR file with the VDM data that we have just exported. We need to tweak a few settings to make it work. Vector displacement set to on, then in the stroke tab, the stroke method should be changed to anchored, and now technically it should work. Just to make it match the original sculpted data better, the strength should be set to 1. Cool, it definitely works! That's how VDM brushes work. Look at how it captured the overhanging parts too. And this is it, that's the basic process of creating custom VDM brushes in Blender.
This is a full game asset workflow with all of the fundamentals covered and a complete step-by-step ancient wall project in Blender, presented by me, AD Burrows, and Gleb Alexandrov of Creative Shrimp.